One of the most used and trustful routes in networking, static routing. In this lesson, we will focus on static routing, and after this lesson, you will be ready to write static routes on Cisco devices. If you are ready, let's go. What is routing? Routing is the process of selecting the path which is used to send data from one node to another. Here is the path determination. Routing is this. It works on layer 3, and it works on routers. Routers do route calculations, and with these route calculations, they determine the best path. And after that, a router sends the data to the related destination. There are two types of routing. One of them is static routing, and the other one is dynamic routing. Static routing is the focus point of this lesson, and dynamic routing is related with routing protocols. So, in the following lessons, we will focus on also dynamic routing protocols, and these are the most important and most popular lessons between network engineers. Yes, static routing is a manual route configuration. What do we mean by manual route configuration? You should write all the things by yourself. In other words, you should teach routes to the routers. Because of this, it is difficult to write static routes in large networks because there are too much devices, too much routes. For this reason, static routing is used in small networks. Think about this. You have a lot of routers, a lot of destinations. How can you use static route in a large network? Certainly, we use static routes in large networks for some parts, for practical usage. In a large network, we generally use routing protocols for routing. There is no need for extra resources for static routing. You need only your own resource, your own brain. Here are route preferences, administrative distance values. As you can see on the screen, all the Cisco default values are here, and connected is 0, and static route administrative distance is 1. And static route is the most trustful route. As you know, connected is not a route. They preferred over routing protocol routes because, as you can see on the screen, the routing protocol default administrative distance values are higher than static routes. So, static route is preferred over routing protocol routes. Some different vendors has different administrative distance preference values. For static route, Cisco default is 1, Nokia default is 1, Juniper is 5, and Huawei is 60. Let's talk about static routing on a topology. Here, we are on a router A, and we will teach router A that go to this X destination through this Y destination. For example, we can say that go router E through router D. Let's give an example with this topology, and here are our IP addresses and interface names, and here we will say the same thing. For static routing, we will use IP route, destination network IP, destination subnet mask, and next hop IP address. This is our Cisco command. For this example, our destination network IP is 60.0.0.0, and the destination subnet mask is 255.255.255.0. And the next hop IP address is the IP address of router D interface 30.0.0.2. So our command is IP route 60.0.0.0 255.255.255.0 30.0.0.2. Are there any way to write the same static route? Yes, there is a way. We will do it. Small difference here. We will use interface name instead of next hop. So here the interface name will be the outgoing interface of the source. For this example, we will write IP route 60.0.0.0 255.255.255.0 and gigabit ethernet 0/3. This is the outgoing interface of router A. Yes, guys, we have finished our lesson, and now it is time to test your knowledge. We will see that if you learn this lesson correctly or not. Let's go. Question 1. Which one is the network device responsible for routing? This is a piece of cake for you. Hub, layer 2 switch, router, firewall, all of them. So I will not wait for this question, and this is router. Another easy question is, on which network device do we write static routes? I think you know also this answer, and this is router. I have written two static routes for you. This is your turn. Let's see that if we can write these static routes correctly or not. Here is our topology and here is our question. Write a static route from router A to router E through router B. Router A to router E through router B. How can you write this static route in a Cisco router? I'll give you some time here. Yes, here you are. IP route 40.0.0.0.255.255.255.0 and 10.0.0.2. As you can see here, this 10.0.0.2 is the interface IP address of router B. You can also write this with the block command with gigabit ethernet 0/1 interface name. Let's go to the next question, and the next question is, write a static route from router E to router A through router C. And this is the reverse static routing. And here, what is the answer for you? Yes, our answer is IP route 20.0.0.0.255.255.255.0 and 50.0.0.1. We can also write this with the below command. IP route 20.0.0.0.255.255.255.0 and gigabit ethernet 0/2. And here is the last question. Write a static route from router C to router D through router A. I am asking a little complex. How is it going? I think you will answer this correctly. And after this lesson, you will be ready to write static routes on real routers. Yes, our answer is IP routes 30.0.0.0.255.255.255.0 20.0.0.1. And here, this IP address, this next hop IP address is the interface of router A. We can also write this with the interface name, the outgoing interface name of router C, gigabit ethernet 0/1. Yes guys, this is the end of our static route lesson. If you like this video, please do not forget to like and share. And also do not forget to subscribe our channel. Good luck.